can't cover this out. Camera's on the other side. Hi, my name is Brian. Welcome to another video on derivatives. In this video, we're going to do some more examples about the chain rule. Now, the formula for the chain rule is you're going to differentiate the outside function f, and you're going to leave the inside alone. So the inside function is g. And then you are going to multiply by the derivative of the inside function, which in this case is g prime. So the chain rule is how we deal with differentiating functions that are composition of functions. So in this case, in this video, we're going to actually do a derivative of a composition of three functions. So that would be taking the derivative of a function f of g of h of x. Okay. It still works the exact same way. You're going to start on the outside and you're going to work your way in. So first we'll take the derivative of the outside function. So come down here, which is going to be f. And so you got f prime. Then you're going to leave the inside alone. So that's g of h of x. Then you're going to multiply by the derivative of the inside. Well, the derivative of the inside is another chain rule, so its outside function is g. So we're going to have g prime, and then you will leave its inside alone, which is h of x. And then finally, you take the derivative of inside g, which is h, and so that will be h prime of x. And so that's the chain rule using three functions. So let's take a look at an example. We're going to have the derivative tangent of x to the 2/3 minus sine all raised to the fifth. So you can see that it's a composition of three functions. We have the outside function, which is the, you know, fifth power. Then you have inside, which is tangent. And then you have a function inside tangent. Okay, let's start with the outside function, which is the all this stuff raised to the fifth power. So we're going to bring this 5 down in front. We're going to leave all of the inside alone. That. And then subtract 1 off the exponent, which gives me 4. You are then going to multiply by the derivative of the inside. So the derivative of tangent is then secant squared. And then you're going to leave it inside alone. Because I'm going to run out of room, I'm going to have to erase this. So the inside of secant squared is x to the 2/3 minus sine. And then you're going to multiply by the derivative of the inside. So the derivative of x to the 2/3 is 2/3 x to the negative 1/3 minus. And then the derivative of negative sine is negative cosine. All right, I think that's pretty good for this video. A composition of three functions can be a little tricky. So anyways, I hope this example helps. Good luck. Bye.